Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here in Rise of the Tomb Raider, and last where we left off, we were gathering supplies to kill a bear. Now, guess what we're gonna do? Not looking forward to this. Really not looking forward to this. But, anyway, life is life. I can't believe only 9% done. Alright, so, we were collecting mushrooms to basically mix it into our arrows to create some poison arrows so it would help us in our fight against the angry bear. So we have to find out what happens now.
This discovery is too important. I don't give a damn about my reputation. Don't you dare threaten me after everything I've done. Hello? Hello?
Dad, what's happening?
They're fools!
You're scaring me.
I'm close, Lara. Close to something important. Someday, you'll understand.
I don't want to understand. I just want you to stop. Be my dad again!
Turtle legs. Uh-oh.
Keep moving! Come on! We got him! Keep running! Go!
Yeah, let's not use her as a hostage. And what, you didn't notice the fire over there? There you go. But before we kill the bear, we gotta deal with it.
Teams report in. What's the situation? Over.
We found another camp up here. Fire was still warm.
Oh.
Command, we're fanning out to pick up the trail.
Roger that, but it looks like they've retreated. Primary objective is to find a missing survey team.
Oh, that was excessively violent.
Spread the word. The natives set snares in the clearing. They must have planned for us to pursue. God damn it. They weren't retreating. This was a feint. They're still out there. Brinker's KIA. Someone's gonna have to...
Come here. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I am in a... Okay. So So give me 1 second here, folks. I will get right back to you. Just give me a moment. Okay, sorry about that. Technical difficulties. Sorry. Got interrupted. Had a friend wanting to come and do a multiplayer. So I kind of had to stop my recording, so. Alright, so what we were doing was we ran into some Trinity soldiers and they were hunted down some of the locals.
Shit.
So now I have to go in and hunt these guys.
The natives set snares in the clearing. They must have planned for us to pursue. God damn it. They weren't
Alright, so we are now hunting these guys to basically try to deal with them and try to help out this one individual who has escaped. So now we have to play either sneak or kill them all. I always like preferring the sneak method, but when in doubt, just
get on the radio, see if you can raise the facility. Last signal we got said they were under attack, then nothing. That was just a few minutes after the natives hit us outside the ruins.
Then they retreated away from the facility. This was a coordinated feint. They're trying to spread us out. Intel crew fucked this up. These aren't peasants. We're gonna need counterinsurgency protocols. It'll blow the timetable. Constantine's not gonna like this, but it's better than getting picked off in the dark.
Alright, so I have Poison Cloud. I think if I have it, I'm going to try.
We're under attack! Sweep and clear. She's there! Open fire!
I think that's everyone. Hey, the document that was missing earlier.
We're gearing up. I was on the first flight to Siberia to secure the old Soviet installation now. More arriving every minute. Constantine gave a speech to the new boots, and I stayed in the back to watch. Love hearing him speak. Never gets old. I was never much for believing, but it was just words before this is something more. It's truth. I was broken once. Trinity is making us whole again, giving us a purpose. A new world awaits. Even those who don't believe will have a part to play.
It's interesting, like, when you hear these recordings and you just hear, like, the psyche, like, how the psyche of some of these individuals are. It just kind of shows how influential Constantine is and how influential Trinity is. Oh. I think I have to go back in.
The natives are clear out the woods.
I heard, yeah, someone was still here. Wait, that's weird. I heard a radio saying they still booby trapped the woods. Unless he's in the cave. Well, let's just take this on the safe side. I have to get some shrooms anyway for some death caps. In the cave again. Okay, oh, okay, I never used them. Okay, I was wondering, why didn't I use them? I need wood. I have feathers. That's good. That's important. I'm surprised I haven't, like, looted a, looted any guns, like firearms from these guys. It's crying out loud. I just killed like how many of these guys? Alright, I'm gonna check the map here. Might go for one last thing. If I can get to this, I'm gonna get this survival cache and then I'm gonna head out. Resources and money. I got a piece of wood. Oh wait. Turn around. Please, turn around. Why? Because I don't want to do this. I want to see where he goes. Come on, turn. Turn around. Okay. We're gonna go this way. Around. Do I get this place? Ooh, ancient coins. Oh, damn. Yeah, that last guy was just a fluke. Usually, I think when I played there the past couple times, I came across one guy, and that just messed up my entire, like, stealth run. I know there's one guy left. I just have to find him. Because I hear him chatting, I hear him talking. So I know he's here somewhere. I'm gonna grab some. Oh wait, I think I know where he is. If not, I'm just listening to the radio transmissions in my radio. Oh. Okay, never mind. Alright, never mind. All the animals have come back. That's kind of a signal saying that this area is clear. Alright, let's head on out. The animals have returned. Alright, we are go. No. Get distracted. Alright. Up. Alright. So. This time, instead of running, we are relying on our poison arrows.
Damn. It's still there.
Alright, so remember, I died once this thing by not by messing up my thing. Stuff here. Wood. Yeah, that doesn't attract the bear. I crack open a crate. I hear you. Oh, I have to go inside. Oh, this is not gonna go well. Oh, Oh, nice. They gave me death caps. Thank you.
Too cramped to fight. Better to draw it out. Bought some time.
Yes! Poison clouded to death. Got some bear hide. Poison cloud arrow. I'm gonna explore this cave. Why? Because he was guarding something. Alright. Resources? Ooh, more resources. Food. Ooh, scroll.
The fugitive prophet has crossed out of the Empire and now turns north. I'm now in unfamiliar territory. The Order of Trinity was clear. I am to pursue the false prophet and his adherents to the ends of the earth and wash away his heresy. But I believed I could overtake him months ago. Still, he eludes me. He crosses Khazar land and across the Caucasus mountains. Here, I'm at a disadvantage. I speak a dozen tongues of the Empire, but in the hinterlands, I'm often left to communicate with little more than a sword. The prophet, it seems, speaks every language, as if you were born to them.
It's interesting that these are all narrated very well. I like that, though. Oh, what? Ooh, a baby box. What do we got? Semi-auto pistol part, 104. So there are pistol parts there. Pry open strong boxes to reveal weapon parts and upgrade tools. Collect all parts of a weapon to unlock it at base camps. So I enjoyed doing these little scrummages for this stuff like this, but now that I've played this a couple times, I kind of have an idea what some stuff is, but I'm not really... I really want to try to collect stuff, but at the same time, I also want to try to see how quickly I can finish this game. Well, I already know what's about to happen here. Let's do this. Aha! Ooh, scroll.
He's passed through the lands of the Rus. I cannot shake the feeling that he's taunting me, waiting until I'm a day's ride away before moving on. I will not be home before the winter, as I hoped. I've stopped at a small village by a glassy lake they called Svetloyar. The prophet spoke here, and now the villagers refuse me lodging. I slept on the banks of the lake, where a young man, bearing a crude version prophet's icon, tried to kill me as I dozed. I made an example of him, and now the people fix me with the evil eye, spit at me as I pass. I must move on soon. His sickness spreads.
It's amazing when you have ideologies face off against one another. All right, moving on. But I love how, like, the architect, like, basically, like, how this glacials form. And look at that.
Shit, that's gonna be cold.
Well, took the words right out of my mouth there, Lara. Ooh, what's in here? Oh, another box.
An arrowhead carved from bone. This looks like Mongol craftsmanship.
Alright, let's zoom on in. Let's turn it.
This was a whistling arrow. Mongol archers would fire these over their enemies to frighten and confuse them.
All right, time for a freezing dip. Let's do this. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, base camp. I'm gonna check if there's anything to search for. Hold on. Hoop. Money, resources, of course. Oh, another chest. Resources. All right, base camp. I think it might be time for a monologue. Let's take a look. Nope. Okay. All right. So when you get enough base camps, when you get to another base camp, you're able to activate the fast travel option. So let's go take a look. So we have one base camp over here, like where we survived the avalanche. Main base camp where we survived the avalanche. So we can pop back over here. It tells us all of our stuff here that we've discovered. I've pretty much gotten everything except for the two relics, because those are behind areas that I need specific equipment that I acquire later in the game in order to come back to. So this actually, the fast travel system makes it a little bit easier, so when I get new stuff, I'm able to basically bounce back and go grab that stuff and move on. So I may be showing that stuff in, I might cut it in, I might cut it out, but I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. So for right now, I am gonna kind of stay here and notice that there are 4 documents, 3 relics, and 1 treasure in the region I'm in right now. In the Glacial Caverns, there is 6 items for my search. So I'm going to, like I said, I am a fan of the bow. So I like when I increase the the bow, and same goes with my axe. Oh, I didn't realize that. Okay. Alright, so I have increased the ability of my, well, I have some skill, or I have a skill. Alright, so I have, so far, epic crafting, resourceful combatant, Zeri bombs, Lightfoot, eye for detail. So I'm gonna go eye for detail here. There you go, so that should help me find items a little bit easier. Alright, so now we are moving on. We have saved. So now I have the survival instinct, I can see a little bit better. Go across here. And now we have the option to go to optional tombs. Like I said on the fast travel map. Give me the option, so now I have to be careful.
A Byzantine war galley. How the hell did it get down here?
I'm judging by the entrance right there. I'm saying it somehow found its way down here through time, over time.
It's Mongolian. They passed through here. I must be close to the lost city.
Alright, so this is a challenge too. This will allow me to get some cool artifacts and possibly some new weapons. Like,
must be something up there.
Maria Adula is trapped. The ice gave way. Her spine snapped in two. No matter. Well, I hope to wield her cannons against the false prophet. We will continue on foot. I have six of the Order of Trinity's best, and we have been stockpiling food and supplies while the sailors starved. They do not know it yet, but they will give their life for the cause. My men and I will find our way out of these icy caves and continue on foot. Before the ship was swallowed by the ice to the south, we heard music. That will be our first stop. But first I must rest. The cold has sunk into my bones, and I am drowsy. Just a little sleep.
Guaranteed, he probably died. Okay. So, this is it. Now, question is, do I have the means to even do this challenge?
Got to crack the ice somehow.
Oh, clever. Yes. How convenient.
Got it. Now to find out what's up there.
Alright, so I found the way to go around. Alright. Also, I apologize for them, but solving these puzzles, I usually kind of stay pretty quiet. It's like, could have done it the other way, but hey, I could do another little adventure. Alright. Yep. Well, sitting in the ice for how long? I'm surprised it hasn't fallen apart with the fact that small, but it's still a difference in body weight for a long period of time. Alright, what do we got?
Look at all this. Why were they carrying so much wealth with them?
Alright, so we got a map. We got a map update, we got a treasure map, and we got a coin, and another.
It's done. We'll die here, thanks to Corraldus and the madness of the Order of Trinity. My ship will never see water again. We entered the Glacial Sea too far into the winter. Would have been turned back, but Corraldus would not abandon this lost prophet. He and his dead-eyed warriors seized control. He forced the ship through shallow tributaries until we could go no further. Then he made my crew construct sled runners, and the bastard forced us to tow the ship over land. It was death and excommunication to deny him. But it was death either way. I will make sure he dies here with us. I've always kept a little poison at the ready in case the ship was taken. Now, it has another use.
Oh boy. It seems that Trinity is very aggressive when it comes to hunting down certain things. But let's open up this and see what we got.
This codex details the archery techniques of the foes of the Byzantine Empire.
Ancient abilities. Quickly shoot up to 2 successive arrows. Yes, challenging. And the brilliant part about when you complete a tomb, look at the easy act. He's like, how am I going to get out of here when I'm all the way up here? Easy. Zipline. And a quick slide down. And I'm back to where I was.
A Byzantine brooch. The enamel work is beautiful.
Alright, I gotta turn this thing around.
This portrait has been defaced. It looks like it was depicting the prophet. They must have had to hide their faith.
Alright, so my Greek is almost a level 2. Alright, see. I knew I missed something. There's 2. Oh my goodness, there's 2 relics. I missed 2. Oh, I missed 1 relic. Just 1 relic. My base camp. But I will get to that when I am done with this thing. I'm not backtracking all the way over there. Just alright. Let's continue on. Oh, we are almost out actually. Oh, I'm so naive. Okay. Actually, I'm deciding right now. Oh! Oh, another dot, another swim. Let's do this! I might drown. I didn't drown. But I need to heal. Yeah, you can actually get hurt pretty bad by drowning in here. Alright, so we are out of the glacial, but we're still in a cave system. Oh, yeah, this is gonna go well. But it did. Alright. Oh, we are near our base camp. I think we're near the Soviet. Yes, we're near the Soviet installation. So we should be near our base camp. So, by base camp, yes, I can hear the newest narration from Miss Croft.
I'm not your enemy. That remains to be seen. You killed those men back there. I killed them to survive. I suspect you did too. How long have they been here?
Days, at most. The invaders took many of my people prisoner. You should leave this place before it's too late.
I can't do that. I came here for something important.
So did they. If I see you again, I'll put an arrow in your throat.
You and I are on the same side. I hope I can prove that to you. What's going on down there?
Who? Prison break. She's Batman. Why is there always someone that has to be like Batman, like when it comes to disappearing? But either way, I got a prison camp and a monologue. Monologue time.
So, there are people who live out here, and they appear to have been here for a very long time, living in isolation for decades, maybe even centuries. I notice elements of her dress, small adornments that would not have been out of place in the Byzantine Empire. Could they possibly be descendants of the Prophet's people? How much do they know about the lost city or the divine source? It's clear Trinity will do anything to find out. I'm afraid that whoever they are, they're in grave danger. Let's hope the old proverb about the enemy of my enemy remains true.
Well, I'm not so sure about the enemy of my enemy of my enemy, because that would still make them my enemy. Yeah. They were smart to basically stop it at the enemy of my enemy is my friend. Alright, so let us get ourselves set up. I think we'll go with dodge counter on this one. Alright. Alright, so we are gonna go and go over here first. See, it gives me a summary of everything that I'm here when I'm in a specific area. So I got a new little piece of equipment. Maybe I could use that to level myself up now. Hold on, let's do this. Nope. Alright, so before we end this part, I'm gonna go fast travel back to the base camp here and go get that one relic I missed. So, I said the relic was right there, so I had to go back under here. Oh, turn right. There you go. Yeah, pop this.
A paisa. A sort of passport. Whoever held this spoke with the authority of the Mongol Empire. It reads, by the power of eternal heaven, an order of the Empire, whoever does not show respect will be guilty of an offense.
If you're having a bad day, you have to force a smile on yourself. So, happy. Alright, so we are gonna go ahead back up to base camp here. I'm gonna use fast travel and head back to base camp by the installation. Because the Lost City is in some sort of Russian installation. Brilliant. Just brilliant. Alright, so I'm going to set myself a base camp here, and we are going to call this apart. This is actually very interesting to be able to check out the optional tomb and be able to find out maps and meetups with the locals. Or at least one of the locals. So this is the end of part 3, and yeah, I'll see you in part 4, guys. Peace.